Remember, in one of my previous videos, I discussed the three central aspects of a good design according to the Roman architect Vitruvius, which are stability, utility, and beauty. In the past, designers were so worried to fulfill this third condition, beauty, such that they had to use proportions that ensures a natural harmony and a balanced hierarchy of skills called the golden ratio. The golden ratio comes from the Fibonacci sequence, which was first introduced by Leonardo of Pisa and later theorized by the Greek philosopher Plato. Two quantities are said to be in golden ratio when the ratio of the sum of the two quantities to the larger one is the same as the ratio of the larger quantity to the smaller quantity. Represented by the Greek letter phi, the golden ratio has a numerical value of 1 plus square root of 5 all divided by 2, which of course is a rational number and can be approximated to 1.168. It can also be called the golden cut, the golden section, the golden mean, the divine cut, or the divine proportion. This golden ratio is believed to give the most aesthetic proportions for a rectangle called the golden rectangle. The golden rectangle is simply one whose side dimensions are in the golden ratio. These types of rectangles have a property of self-similarity, meaning that a golden rectangle can be divided into a square and a smaller golden rectangle, which will in turn be divided into a smaller square and a smaller golden rectangle, and the pattern continues. In 1943, the Swiss-born architect Le Corbusier took advantage of this knowledge of golden ratio and interpreted this knowledge in a different way, which he called the modulo, a specific module whose arrangement rule is based on the golden number. To define these measures, Le Corbusier started with the modular man with a height of 1.83 meters with an extended arm giving a total height of 2.26 meters. By setting the navel height at 1.13 meters, he obtained two squares dividing the modular man. He then applied the golden section starting from the lower part of the square by constructing golden rectangles again and again, which became small as the dimensions of the squares decreased. He made sure the sequence of measures obtained follows the Fibonacci series, that is, the next term is the sum of the two previous ones. He called this series the red series. He obtained the blue series by doing the following geometric construction, and of course, just as in the red series, they followed the Fibonacci series. With this method, Le Corbusier succeeded in combining the foot-based Anglo-Saxon measurement of system, also known as imperial, with the metric decimal system. The golden ratio has influenced the shape of several buildings throughout history and is somehow believed to be responsible for any balance and harmony these buildings possess. For instance, the facade of the Parthenon in Rome is believed to have been designed based on the golden rectangle, thus making this facade pleasing to one's eyes and creating harmony in space. Others even claim that the Great Egyptian Pyramid was designed such that the ratio of the slant height of the pyramid to half of the length of its base gives the golden number phi. A building with aspect ratio satisfying the golden section almost has some magical and aesthetic properties. And what if all of these were just a simple misconception or a coincidence? Is the golden rectangle really pleasing aesthetically to the human eye? Based on scientific experiments and historical proofs, some researchers do not totally agree the existence of this golden factor in architecture. Two experimental results by George Markowski, a mathematician, proves that 1. People do not prefer rectangles with aspect ratio, the golden mean, to other rectangles, and 2. People cannot even identify a golden rectangle when placed amongst other rectangles. Hence, disproving the widely circulated claim that a rectangle with aspect ratio phi gives maximum visual pleasure to the observer. The belief that the facade of the Parthenon being designed based on the golden rectangle may have been founded on several misunderstandings. The Greeks, when constructing this temple, achieved what we call entasis, that is, they made the shafts of the columns swell in order to avoid optical distortions from perspective views. This therefore gives a slightly curved geometry to the entire facade of the Parthenon rather than a perfect rectangle. Furthermore, a very careful geometrical analysis by Ernest Berger on the facade of the Parthenon reveals that the most obvious rectangle was most probably built to have aspect ratio 9:4, which is very far from the golden number. For sure, the golden ratio exists in nature, but its use in the field of architecture may have been exaggerated. Many of today's modern architects do not use these golden numbers and ratios, but they still succeed in bringing out this beauty. With this, I thank you for listening to this video and hope to see you later.